Hello crafty friends, it's Alicia of the Call Me Crafty I YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be making a card using the new Hands of Love stamp set from Gina K Designs. I hope you'll stick around and see what I'm going to create. Thank you so much for stopping by today. If this is your first time to my channel, I hope that by the end of this video, you'll be inspired to click on that subscribe button below and maybe even tap on that bell for notifications. If you're already a subscriber and regular viewer, welcome back. I'm so glad that you're here again. A couple weeks ago, Gina K Designs released their Nature's Touch card kit, and I'm here today to make a slimline card using one of the stamp sets from the kit and one of the stencils. Currently, this kit is sold out, and normally they don't restock it, they just wait until they sell it in parts, but because of how quickly it sold out and how many people still wanted it, they are going to do a restock. So I will link it below if you want to go check it out and see if it's in stock if you're interested in purchasing it. I'll tell you a little bit more about the other products I'll be using today, and then we'll get into the process. Just so you know, when I do start the process, I'll go to a voiceover. If I leave you with any questions, make sure to leave those in the comment section below. Besides the items from the card kit, I got out a rainbow of Gina K Designs ink spots. These are all from her summer collection. I grabbed 5 of my blending brushes. And here recently I found a use for my washi tape stash because it just sits there. These blending brushes come from the Dollar Tree, and special shout out to my mom who found me enough so I could have one for each color, because for some reason my stores only have those teeny tiny ones. So I'll be using those as well as my VersaFine Onyx Black, and I got out a piece of Nina Solar White and a piece of black cardstock. Let's get crafty. For my card base, I cut the 11-inch side of my piece of white cardstock down to 7 inches. Then I folded that in half for a slimline card that is 3.5 by 8.5. And the piece that I cut off the cardstock will end up being where I do my stamping and stenciling. I'm not sure if you've seen it yet, but the other day Christina Werner put out a video where she shared some free printables that she created to do her card sketches on. I thought it was a great idea, but I don't use A7 cards, and that was what one of her mixes was. So I created my own, and you'll see here at the bottom that I sketched out what I want this first card to look like and put down some of the dimensions. Now I realize that the top of the paper was cut off, so here is a look at what that sheet looks like. I will link that video from Christina in the description box below. The piece of cardstock that I'm gonna stamp and stencil on, I cut down to 2.25 by 7.25. And then my black cardstock, which will be the mat for that piece, I cut down to 2.5 by 7.5. And now it's time to do the stenciling. I will get this out of the way that I have very rarely used stencils, so I am kind of learning as I go here. What I do know today is I want the heart that the hands create to have red ink behind it. So right now I'm trying to figure out the layout that I want, so when I place my stencil, I know where to start with that red. Today I will be holding my stencil in place with my Scotch Blue removable tape. You know I love this stuff. I don't have any of the purple tape yet, but I'm definitely gonna look into getting that. But for today, this worked just fine for me. Once I had that tape down, I replaced down my stamp and I made a mental note of where my red should start. And now let's get inky. I will be using a different brush for each color today. So the first one I pulled out was my red brush, and you'll notice that before I go to my cardstock, I kind of tap it off a little bit over on that scrap on the right side. I start with the red where I wanted it to be in my stamped hands, and then I just go in rainbow order and just kind of spread out from there. You'll see later that I had to come back in with the red because it kind of went from like a dark red to a pink to an orange, and I wanted it to just go a little bit more smoothly in rainbow order and make sure that that was nice and bright behind the heart in my hands. Before I could move on to the green, I had to relay down my stencil, and the awesome thing about it is this stencil does match up, so you can keep going as far down as you want. So I got that aligned, added my tape to the back, and finished my rainbow. While I finish up that rainbow, I wanted to ask you, do you follow me on Instagram? If not, I hope you'll consider it. Yesterday I shared a sneak peek at this card, and I often do that. If you want to go over there, I am at @callmecraftyal. I would love to have you join me. And now for the big reveal. I'm starting to understand why other crafters like it when they pull their stencil off their cardstock. And now let's do some stamping. I did go ahead and pull out my Misty. Since these stamps are new and I might have to ink them up and stamp them twice, this ensures that I'm going to get the stamp in the exact same place. I made sure that when I placed my stamp down onto my stenciled piece, that the heart in the hands would land in that red area. Once I had that arranged, I picked the stamp up with the door of the Misty and stamped it once. And honestly, it stamped pretty nicely, but I decided to just go ahead and ink it up one more time for a nice deep black. And now it's time to stamp the sentiment. I got my two stamps arranged where I wanted them on the card, and then I picked them up with my Misty and did the stamping. Now you will notice I kind of rubbed the stamp with my finger. That was a trick that I got from watching Gina K. When stamps are new, that just helps it pick up ink. Now I will tell you that if I had this card to do over again, I would probably move the hands a little more to the right and do the sentiment on the left, but at this point, I was gonna make this work because it still looked okay. Now that all of the parts are done, it's time to start getting the card put together. The first thing I'm gonna do is add adhesive to the back of my focal point and get that matted with that black cardstock. Now I do wanna add a little dimension to the card since right now it's just one layer, so I want to add this with some foam tape. To do this, I bring in my big blue roll of foam tape. If you've been around my channel very long, you know that I love this. I get it on Amazon and it's super economical. It is great for shaker cards because it's thin enough for like small frames, and it's also not too thick. It's probably about the depth of a Stampin' Up! Dimensional. Now, Amazon also sells like 1-inch wide rolls. I think I might actually look into that because here I had to put on 3 strips so it would stand nicely on the card. And I think if I had some wider, it might make a little bit more economical sense on stuff like this. If you would like to check out the foam tape, I do have it linked in the description box below. Once I have that foam tape on there, I just center that on the front of the card. I could have totally stopped here, but I decided that my card needed a little bit of shine or sparkle. So I brought in some Nouveau crystal drops, and I'm gonna add those to the front. Now, because my card isn't laying flat, and I do need these drops to dry flat, not to run down the card as it does, I did get some glue off my ATG and make a couple little balls in my fingers. Now by doing this, it takes off some of the extra adhesive, but it makes the card lie nice and flat. I started by placing drops at the bottom of some of the fans in the design, and then I filled in the heart that the hands made. I thought that this would help make that stand out and maybe make that red shine a little bit more. Now I will tell you that when I set it aside to dry, I decided that maybe it needed some more Nouveau drops. So I did go back in and add a little drop at the bottom of each of the fan designs. And here are a couple close-up looks. I hope you enjoyed getting to see how I made the card today. If you did, as always, I appreciate a thumbs up. Until my next video, I hope you're all having a crafty day. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch all the way to the end of the video. I hope now you'll consider clicking on one of the videos or playlists I have linked above, and if you're interested in any of the products or tools I used in today's video, I do have some links in the description box.